Do you ever need to find duplicates on two separate worksheets in Excel? I'm Chris Menard. Let me walk you through this right now. Before I jump into the two separate worksheets, we're going to end up using the COUNTIF function. Over here in column H, I have a lot of cities. Just a quick review of COUNTIF. It has two arguments. I'm going to highlight the cities. And what is it I'm looking for? Let's just say I'm looking for Atlanta. It is not case sensitive. I get the number 2. You can also come in here and type in Atlanta in a separate cell and then reference that cell. There is the formula that I use. We're going to do something very similar right here with the two worksheets. So the two worksheets are called List 1 and List 2. If you look at the employee ID in List 1, I have employee ID 1 through 6 over here. If I go to List 2 and click, I am missing employee ID 4, 6, and employee ID 8 is missing. But if I go back to List 1, I don't even have an employee ID 8, so that one's off the table. If we do this, the answer should be employee ID 4 and 6. We will use COUNTIF. I'm going to go to cell E2, equal COUNTIF, and then what is my range? Go click on your other worksheet. So I'm going to the List 2 worksheet. I'm going to highlight A2 to A7. I need to make those absolute cell reference, so I will press the F4 function key. I'm going to do a comma. Here comes argument number 2. What is your criteria? I'm going to go back to the List 1 worksheet, and I will select cell A2. That is it. You can press Enter. I got the number 1 because 1001 is on both worksheets. Let's autofill down with a double click, and there's my 0 and 0 that we said we would get. So this is correct. If you don't like the 1s or the 0s, and let's say you want true or false, easy to do. I'm going to go back to cell E2. I'm going to go up to the formula bar and I'm going to just say, let's just say, is this greater than 0? So now I've got a true and I should have a false in here. Perfect. By the way, easy tip for you about conditional formatting. If you wanted to conditional format these, you could highlight E2 to E7, go to conditional formatting, highlight cells rules equal to. If I type in the word true, you can see that it's already working. But I want to select the entire row. So I'm going to hit cancel. So that was correct what we just did. To select the entire row, you want to highlight E2 to E7. Don't pick up your header row. Conditional formatting, new rule, use a formula to determine which cells to format. And your formula is simply equal $E2. That single dollar sign is called a mixed reference. I'm freezing column E, but I'm not freezing the rows. Equal true. Go to format in the bottom right. Pick a fill color or a font color. You can also do border if you want to. I picked yellow. Click OK. Click OK. And there you go. If you want to do the entire row right there. I'm going to clear that out. Instead of undo, I'll go the official way and go to manage rules. And I'm going to delete the rule. If you wanted to edit the rule, there's edit. Perfect. One more item here. If you wanted to see yes or no or whatever word you want, I'll do this one more time. Before I do it, I do want to reference using formula text, the function we use. In cell E2, there's what we did. And then in cell F2, we haven't done this one yet. Just give your header row a name. I'm going to do Control R just to pull that Excel formula over. It does say false. If you notice up in the formula here, the A2 to A7 is still correct, but we need to go reference cell A2, not cell B2. So it's just a quick change. Same exact that I have in cell E2 right now. Just add something logical to it, which would be an if function. So let's do equal if. We're going to do our count if. In the if function, what's the value of true? You can make this say whatever you want it to. I'm going to put dupe for duplicate, comma. Value of false, I'm actually going to do quotes, which is a blank. There you go. Let me reference that Excel function. I will have this file available for you to download. I'll keep the answers on the screen. So just come in here. highlight column E, highlight E2 to F7, and then you can do these functions here, and I'll make these static so they stay on your screen. Thank you for your time. My online training is available. Have a wonderful day.